गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर थर्ड सेमेस्टर मैकेनिकल स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई विल डिस्कस चैप्टर थर्ड दैट इज प्रॉपर्टीज प्रोसेसेस ऑफ परफेक्ट गैस। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट इज परफेक्ट गैस? ए परफेक्ट गैस और एन आइडियल गैस इज दैट व्हिच ओबेज ऑल द गैस लॉज अंडर ऑल कंडीशंस ऑफ टेम्परेचर एंड प्रेशर। देन लॉज ऑफ परफेक्ट गैस, द फॉलोइंग थ्री वेरिएबल्स कंट्रोल द फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ ए गैस, दैट इज पी प्रेशर, प्रेशर ऑफ द गैस। देन वॉल्यूम, दैट इज वॉल्यूम ऑक्युपाइड बाय द गैस। देन टेम्परेचर, दैट इज टेम्परेचर ऑफ द गैस। These three variables are interconnected with one another by the gas laws. If any two of the above variables of a given mass of a gas are known, then the third can be calculated with the help of gas laws. Laws of perfect gases are that is Boyle's law, Charles' law, Dalton's law of partial pressure. Then what is gas laws? In a non-flow process, that means in which gas does not flow by itself and in which the mass of the gas remains constant, the behavior of a gas is governed by the following laws, that is Boyle's law, Charles' law, Dalton's law of partial pressure. First of all, I will discuss what is Boyle's law. This law states that temperature remaining constant, the volume of a given mass of a gas varies inversely as its absolute pressure. Suppose P is equal to absolute pressure of the gas, then V, volume of the gas, then according to Boyle's law, V is inversely proportional to pressure, or V is equal to C into 1 by P, or PV is equal to C, where C is a constant. If P1 is equal to initial pressure of the given mass of the gas, V1, volume of the given mass of the gas, then P2, final pressure of the gas, or V2 is equal to final volume of the gas, then according to Boyle's law, P1, V1 is equal to C, or P2, V2 is equal to C. That means P1, V1 is equal to P2, V2. This is the statement of Boyle's law. Next, I will discuss what is Charles' law. Charles' law states that the volume of a given mass of a gas varies directly as its absolute temperature. When the absolute pressure remains constant. This statement can be represented as B is directly proportional to T, or B is equal to CT, or B by T is equal to C, where C is a constant. If a gas has a volume V1 at an initial absolute temperature T1, and if at the same absolute pressure its volume changes to V2 such that its new absolute temperature becomes T2, then we can write as V1 by T1 is equal to V2 by T2 or V3 by T3 for different gases. Or we can write as V1 by T1 is equal to V2 by T2. Then I will discuss what is combined gas equation. Now I will discuss what is combined gas equation or general gas equation. When we combine both Boyle's law and Charles' law, we get combined gas equation or general gas equation. We know that from Boyle's law, V is inversely proportional to P, where T is a constant, that means temperature remaining constant. Then according to Charles' law, V is directly proportional to T, where pressure remains constant. When we combine both Boyle's law and Charles' law, we have T, or V that inversely proportional to T by P, or V is equal to C T by P, where T and P remains constant. Then P V is equal to C T, or P V by T is equal to C, where C is a constant whose values depends upon mass of the gas and gas properties. Then this equation can also be written as V1 by T1 is equal to P2 V2 by T2. This is the equation of combined gas equation or general gas equation. Next class, I will discuss what is Dalton's law of partial pressure, Gay-Lussac law, etc. Thank you.